Sabi natin, pwede rin matapos lahat. So meron tayong retirement under Article 300. This article of the Labor Code has been amended by Republic Act 7641. Para saan ba yung retirement? Retirement is an obligation of the employer. Bayaran niya si employee. Bakit? It provides for the retiree's sustenance and hopefully even comfort when he or she no longer has the stamina to continue earning for his or her livelihood. Okay? So employer lang ang required magbayad dito. Kaya lang you have to remember na one-time payment lang ito. No? Pag nabayaran ka na ng retirement pay mo ng employer, wala ka nang aasahan pa dyan. Huh? One time, big time, sabi nila. So in the absence of a retirement plan, dapat yung employee ay 60 to 65. Okay? 60, pwede ka na mag-retire. But remember, early retirement and 60, as I was saying earlier. 65 is the mandatory retirement age. Okay? At ikaw ay naka 5 years. Continuous yung 5 years niyan dyan sa employer mo. Before retirement. Now, you are entitled to 1/2 month salary for every year of service and a fraction of at least 6 months is considered as one whole year. Basta 6 months or more, one whole year na yan. Okay? Now, ano ang entitlement? Parang millennial, ano? Ano ba talaga yung 1/2 month salary? According to the labor code, yan ay 15 days plus 1/12 of the 13th month pay plus the cash equivalent of not more than 5 days service incentive leave. Teka muna. Yung service incentive leave, di ba, pag hindi nagamit within the year, converted into cash equivalent. O bakit idinadagdag pa rin? Ayun ang sabi ng batas eh. Ha? Idinadagdag pa rin dyan. So kaya, sabi ng Korte Suprema, Capitol Wireless versus Confessor and subsequent cases, yung 1/2 month salary shall mean 22.5 days for every year of service. 15 days salary based on the latest salary yan, ha? Plus 2.5. Kasi yung 1 over 12, tandaan ninyo, yung 1 na yan means 30 days, 1 month. So 30 days divided by 12, 2.5 yan. Kasi that's how you compute 13th month pay, di ba? Your salary for 12 months divided by 12. So kaya pang 13. Okay? Eh, 1 over 12 lang. So yung 12 months, gagawin mo 1 month, i-divide mo sa 12. So 30 days divided by 12, that's 2.5. So total, 22.5 days. Okay? That is also the ruling of Santa Catalina College versus NLRC. Huh? And other subsequent cases, iyan po ay consistent. Hindi nagbabago ang ruling ng korte dyan. And according to Enriquez Security versus Cabotaje, that is based on the employee's latest salary rate. Bago siya magretiro. Okay? Hindi yung salary rate niya noong nakaraan pa, hindi. Yung the time before he retires. Ha? Tandaan yan. Now, for underground and surface miners, yan po ay 50 to 60 years old. 50 years old ang early retirement, 60 years old ay mandatory retirement. Well, because of the nature of their job. Diba? Minsan ay exposed po sila sa mga hazardous chemicals. Ano? Okay. So, ganun din ang entitlement nila. Now, retirement must be voluntary. Remember, you cannot compel an employee to retire at an age earlier than 65. Okay? So, allows for optional retirement at the age of at least 60. So, remember, 60 is optional. If the employee does not want to retire at 60, you cannot compel that employee to retire at the age of 60. So, 65 kasi yun yung mandatory retirement age. Maliwanag. Now, yan din ang ruling ng Korte Suprema in that earlier case of Hakulbe versus Silliman University. Na dapat 65 ang mandatory. Well, the case of Hakulbe, you'd realize na merong collective bargaining agreement ang Silliman University with the union na retirement age nila ay 60. But when Mrs. Aculbe reached 60, she did not want to retire. Therefore, sabi ng eskwelahan, teka muna, may CBA tayo, you have to follow the CBA kasi lalo na ikaw, union member ka yata. But according to the court, no. If you retire an employee, it must be voluntary, otherwise it is constructive dismissal, and you also have that case of Cercado versus Uniprom. You need the individual consent of the employee to retire at an age earlier than 65. Okay? Now, doon naman sa contributory retirement plan. Kasi sa some Catholic schools, katulad nitong kaso ng Santa Catalina College, nagko-contribute ang employee every month or every payday as the case may be. Contribute siya. Pagka nagretiro siya, yung contribution niya, amount that he has contributed for the duration of his employment to the retirement plan is fully his. It must be removed first before we compute kung magkano na i-contribute ng eskwelahan o ng employer. Eh? So maliwanag yan. Huwag isasama sa computation yung contribution ng employee. Maliwanag ang desisyon ng korte dyan. Now what about as part-time employees? Are we entitled to retirement pay? Yes, because the law did not distinguish whether full-time or part-time, you are entitled to retirement pay provided you have complied with all the requirements of the law. Ano yun? Ikaw ay 60 to 65 years old. You have served your employer at least 5 years prior to retirement. Okay? Maliwanag yan, ha? Now, what about prescription period? Ang prescription period sa Labor Code ay nasa Article 291. Ang sabi ng Korte Suprema, Ariola versus Filipino Star ngayon, kasama dyan yung overtime pay, holiday pay, service incentive leave pay, bonuses, salary differential, and other illegal deductions that are made by the employer. Kasama rin dito sa 3-year prescriptive period, ang claims arising from seafarers' contracts. So pati mga OFW kasali dyan. Eh? Kasi ang OFW hindi naman nagpapile ng illegal dismissal. Ang pinafile niya ay money claims. So kung money claims, 3 years ang prescriptive period natin. Okay? Now in the case of Rodriguez o Protective Maximum Security versus Puentes, iyan yan. Covers all money claims arising from employers' contract from seafarer's contract kasama dyan. Now, the provision, however, does not cover money claims consequent to an illegal dismissal. It does not also cover claims for damages to illegal dismissal. Dahil ang claims daw na ito ay covered by Article 1146. That is true. We'll discuss that. Now, the prescriptive period for filing an illegal dismissal is 4 years. Okay? The 4-year prescriptive period applies and not Article 291. Bakit? Ang kaso kasi dyan dati yung Caliente versus Carnation. Kapag illegal dismissal, hindi 3 years ang prescriptive period, 4 years. Why? 4 years kasi nga ang illegal dismissal as in the case of Victory Liner versus Rase is an injury to a right. So pag injury to a right, ay civil code provision tayo. So, in the case of Victory Liner, ayan, so 1146, napakaliwanag, di ba? Na kapag ka na-dismiss yung employee illegally, his right to property is injured. Therefore, the prescriptive period that we apply is the one under the civil code, not the labor code. 1146 of the civil code says that the following actions must be brought or instituted within 4 years. Number one, upon an injury to a right of the plaintiff. Two, upon a quasi-delict. So maliwanag, pag pure money claims, 3 years from the accrual of the cause of action. Pagka illegal dismissal, 4 years. Because it is an injury to a right. The right to property is injured. However, ayan, ang sabi ng consistent, ano? So, Protective Maximum Security. However, in the case of service incentive leave, 3 years din ang prescriptive period, pero it will start not at the time when it was withheld, but at the time you demanded for its payment. So sa lahat ng money claims, i-separate natin yung service incentive leave. Ano ba yung service incentive leave? Provided under Article 95 of your labor code. That the employee is entitled to at least 5 days service incentive leave with pay. So pag hindi niya ginamit, converted into cash equivalent. Itong si employer, hindi siya nag-commute into cash equivalent. Gamitin o, pag di mo nagamit, wala na yan. The prescriptive period will only start, 3 years then, but it will only start at the time a demand was made. So 3 years ka, 4 years ka hindi binabayaran service incentive leave. Hindi mo kiniklaim. On the 4th year, sabi mo, boss, asan na yung service incentive leave ko? Okay? Doon magsisimula yung prescriptive period. From the time you demanded or upon the termination of your employment. So nag-resign ka, hindi pala nababayaran yung service incentive leave mo, ay tingnan mo. Ha? May record ka ba na hindi ka talaga binayaran? O di i-claim mo. Pag hindi binayaran pa rin, despite your demand, you file a case. You have 3 years to do that from the time you demanded. Okay?